Hello, Squarespace users. All right, so by now you've probably heard that SVG files are an excellent way of having vector on your website. And so in Squarespace, you might assume that you could add a vector image or an icon just like you would an image. So if you try to do that and you click image, and you go to upload a file and you navigate to one, let's say it's an icon, and you will get not supported. You have to have a JPEG, a PNG, or a GIF file to be an image. All right, so do not be discouraged. SVG files are also code. They are an HTML type of code, so you can use the code block instead. So this way, select code, go into edit, and you can literally copy and paste any SVG that you get from any icon set or one that you make in Illustrator or any program that creates SVGs for you and paste it in here. So let me show you an example of using Font Awesome. So I'm looking for the globe. I've clicked, so there are these tabs and I can click the SVG. I can choose the size and the color. And if I click anywhere here, it says it's copied, so I have that snippet copied. So I'm gonna come in and paste it. All right, so a few things that I want you to know specifically with Font Awesome and other SVGs is in the front of it, you'll have your height and width, and that's the size that it's going to show, and you can change that. So I think we're going to do 40, I think is what's consistent. Okay, now the other thing is much further back in your Font Awesome code. Let's see, so we're about maybe a, I don't know what that is in. You're looking for your path fill when it's something solid and there's only one like this, and you can change that color, that hex color, to anything that you want. So that is how you would get an icon into Squarespace, and I will change the color. I'm going to look for consistency so I can come into my other icon and I can see it's actually 45 by 45 and I'm looking for that fill, which is a bit more in. Here's my fill color. I'm going to copy it and I'm going to close. I'll come in. We know this is going to be 45 by 45. I'm going to scroll in a bit. Do my different fill. Yeah, perfect, right? I'm going to head and delete out my other one and paste it in. So one of the nice things about Squarespace is you can use key commands that you're used to using in other programs, especially as designers. So the command C, the command V, you can make and duplicate. You can also grab and drag. So that's using option on a Mac, and that's similar to Adobe products as well. So there's less of a learning curve on functionality in some parts for the visual editor that's in Squarespace. All right, so your workaround to be able to include icons and SVGs on your Squarespace site is to use the code block and to actually copy and paste in your SVG code rather than trying to put it in via images. All right, good luck and enjoy adding images as SVG vectors to Squarespace.